following is a paid program. The opinions expressed are not necessarily those of WNBU and Interbanks Media.
Money. Welcome to All Things Money with David Blain, a thoughtful and revealing discussion of actionable ideas and effective strategies to help you through the complex world of investing, taxes, and real estate. Now, with All Things Money, here's David Blain.
Good morning and welcome to All Things Money. Ordinarily, this is a show hosted by David Blain, and the first thing I'd like to clear up and get on the table is I'm not David Blain. Those of you listening on the radio at 94.1 FM WNBU are like, he sounds a little different. And some of you who are watching on cable TV, Channel 10, are like, that is definitely not David Blain. If you are familiar with our show, you will remember I was on about a month ago and I spoke about IRAs and Roth IRAs and making the decision of when to use one versus the other. And if this is your first time listening to the show, you've perhaps just stopped us on the radio dial thinking you were going to hear some Pink Floyd, and you're not. So the show, the format here is that we operate as an ensemble wealth planning practice here in New Bern, and we take this opportunity on this show to kind of share some of the wisdom that we hope to pass on to our clients, to the broader audience of those that are listening, and try to decipher some of the complexities about the complicated financial world we live in, and hopefully provide you, the audience, with some applications and some things to live by. This morning I'd like to start off talking about pensions. In fact, that's actually not a very precise term. A 401k is technically considered a pension. So to differentiate the two, let me just define some terms. That's probably all I'll have time to do during this first segment, but then I'd like to move into some of the some of the accounting changes that are affecting the way pensions operate internally. So a pension, or what I mean by a pension, is really called a defined benefit program. And what that means is a company or a municipality or a federal government agency has made a promise to their employee that they're going to pay them in retirement a defined that's why it's called a defined benefit. They're defining the benefit. Usually that definition, it may look like 2% of their highest average 5 years of salary times the number of years that they were working for the company, creditable towards the pension, that kind of formula. So if you had somebody that worked there 10 years, they might only get 20% of their income when they're 65 or something like that. Whereas if they work there a long time, they might be able to make up 60-80% of their salary, of their highest salary. So that's what a pension looks like, and it's also called a defined benefit plan because, again, the company is defining a future benefit, a future payout that they're going to provide. In contrast, the defined contribution plan is one where the company decides, okay, that's like a 401k. The company may decide through a profit sharing arrangement that they're going to match a certain amount of the employees' deferrals into the plan, or put some amount into some tax deferred savings vehicle. But ultimately, that savings vehicle belongs to the employee, and it's inside the plan. It's definitely earmarked, and the employee can log into a website and see what their value actually is inside that plan. When the employee leaves that company, they can roll that out into an IRA, an individual retirement account, and that is their money. And so the difference mainly in the two different schemes is that with a defined benefit plan, the employer is assuming the risk of managing the assets that need to go into that plan. So they know they have future liabilities that they're on the hook to pay certain amounts in the future, but in order to be able to do that, they have to manage assets in the present to be able to make good on that promise. Whereas a defined contribution plan, the employee is in control of the assets that their plan is, that their own plan is invested in, and therefore they are assuming the financial risk, where if they they determine that they have the need of, you know, X amount of retirement dollars, they could do the math or, you know, meet with a financial planner such as ourselves. We can help them determine how much they need to contribute into that plan, what sorts of investments are prudent for them to invest in, and they are assuming then the risk and bear the responsibility for the outcome of that plan and whether or not that actually is sufficient for their retirement. So a lot of the landscape about pensions and defined benefit plans, you see less of them than you used to, and there's a few reasons for that. Mainly because the companies don't want to assume that risk of managing of being on the hook for you know, future payments to their employees, and it's you see pensions all the time that fail or you get in trouble, and you think about large mature companies like Ford and other auto manufacturers really, you know, at risk of bankruptcy, honestly, or at risk of their pensions failing. You see it all the time. So the companies don't want to take that risk. Secondly, in 2006, the Pension Protection Act, which aimed at really trying to protect employees from mismanaged pensions, created some rules that made it that made the companies have to, on balance, contribute more to their plans, and it tightened up some of the accounting. So you see companies less and less want to do these defined benefit plans. Although you see, in this area, we deal with a lot of military or military retirees within the public sector. There's probably still a lot of public sector employees do receive a pension or are active members of a pension. But in the private sector, you see more and more companies are gravitating towards defined contribution plans. So with a pension, like I said, the Pension Protection Act of 2006, that tightened up what the companies had to put into their pensions. So with a pension, they're managed in kind of a sophisticated way. I'll have time to go over a couple terms, and then I'll continue in the next segment. So a pension has assets that they manage, and that will be the bonds that they hold, any stock they might hold, and things like that. That's relatively easy to measure what their assets are, and those are called the pension assets. The pension liabilities are measured. If you think about it, they owe, you know, Sally next month they owe her $3,000, and then the next month they owe her another $3,000, and then somebody that they don't owe any money for a long time, but then in 20 years they're going to owe them, you know, $6,000. All of those are measured and brought back to present dollars to, and that's what a pension liability is. And the difference between that pension asset and the pension liability is what makes the plan either overfunded or underfunded. That's about all I have time for before the break. Again, my name is John Gjertsen, and I'm sitting in for your host, David Blain, on All Things Money.